am the 226 Bubbles. My name is Kimberly Geraci, and my mother, Terry Geraci, has just published a new book called The Cradle is Empty. And it was rated top bestseller and is in Books a Million and in Barnes and Nobles and etc. and any other bookstore and you could ever think of. It's in every bookstore anywhere else. But anyway, you might think that this book is very sad, but it isn't. It will change your life. And I am going to tell you a little story from behind the book, from my mother herself. It says, "Dear reader, it's been my sincere desire to share these expressions with you, to give you some insight into what you're feeling and share your pain, regardless to the kinds of loss you've sustained. Your pain can be very overwhelming and debilitating. The people in your life who love you are probably very supportive, but unless you have someone who has walked the same road with you, you may feel very isolated. When my son died, it felt like the world was shattered into a million pieces. I was clueless as to how to put them back together, how to feel like a whole new person again. The answer I found astonished me. There was no way I could fix it by myself. I had to let God be God in my life and allow Him to put these pieces back together. Please join me on this incredible, difficult journey and let my story inspire you to come out and rejoin the human race. The sun will come out tomorrow." And here's a little fun fact about my family. I am a stay-at-home mom, raising two girls and a husband. Writing has always been a passion of mine. And now I'm a newly published writer. In my spare time, I love to crochet, sing, and watch football. That was a little comment from my mother herself, Terry Geraci. We have been through a lot. Has anybody out there on YouTube heard of Hurricane Katrina in 05? Well, anyway, ever since then, I'm speechless because it was very stretching, very stressing. I lost my home, and we didn't have nowhere else to go. So we just went up to Chicago, stayed with my granny, and then my Uncle G called us, "Hey, you can come stay with us." And so we stayed with him until we got an apartment up here in Raleigh. And, So we stayed there for like 5 years. Very stressing for me. I had a hard time there. Until finally, I moved into this beautiful house in Durham. Life is great here at Neil. But back when my brother was born, he was like as big as my hand. Well, not really, but he was small than me. He was very smart. Let's just say, even though I had a 2-month-year-old and he's sitting on my lap and he knows what TV is. Except he was a very kind baby. My brother was my life. And I remember one time I went to go see him in his little room, and I see him standing up in his bed. I'm like, "Giuseppe, what are you doing?" And he just like giggled and just gave me a big smile. And then I took him up out of bed and I hold him and I'm like, "Hey, Ma, Dad, Giuseppe woke up." And my mom's like, "Oh, he did?" And so anyway. So, New Year's Eve, there was this one morning, my mom was getting concerned after my dad came back from putting out the garbage. My mom's like, "Hey, can you go check on Giuseppe?" So we went back there, and to find out that my brother wasn't breathing. And that's when the ambulance came, and then me and my sister were both removed from the apartment. We stayed with some friends that lived nearby that was from our church that we knew. We stayed at their apartment until they came back from the hospital. And I thought that Giuseppe was in a little swing because it was still a setup, but everybody was crying. And I'm like, where's Giuseppe? And she's like, he's dead. And I'm like, how? And she said she didn't know. Then a couple years later, they found out that my brother had died from SIDS, an infant death syndrome. I'm sure you've heard of it. But I believe, in your opinion, do you think it's rare? Well, in my opinion, yes, I don't think it is. Because my mom said that from her research, SIDS is very common. Very, very common. So, please pick up this book today.